This is a production of the Triple Star Amusement Corporation.
The following was recorded sometime earlier.
Tonight's show will be mostly focused on being the second round of the Tournament of Fate, where all the participants from the first round that qualify will match each other for a chance at making it to the final round and subsequently match Madea, Simmons for the CAWmbat Wrestling State Champion. And speaking of champions, here we've got the current reigning defending oldie champion of the Cosmo Curtis Kramer. I'm about to address the CAW Cosmos. Please listen to this. Hello, Cosmos, isn't it?
Oh, well, that's unexpected. Thanks. I appreciate that.
I guess it goes without saying that his opinions do not reflect the views of...
Oh boy, I know that song, and yep, definitely you love.
I already know that here. Oh, exactly. Here we go with the back and forth. I was going to say that. I know he wasn't going to appreciate being spoken so despondently of, and there we go with a little back and forth going on with the champ and the former challenger. And now Bulow holding the champ, and Kramer's just going to hightail it out of there. I think he believes that he has nothing else to prove. I mean, he did win the championship, so what else is there to prove? I mean, I think that's how he thinks. And while he, oh, yes, it is. Rick Taylor, he just got into the play. He's just going to toss Kramer right to the rabid wolf. And here, Bulow taking advantage of it. Holy hell out of... Wait a minute, what's Rick? Wait, he tells us a minute and now he tells us that he had enough? Well, excuse me, Mr. Taylor, I don't get it. Oh, poor. He just wanted to have the last word. I should have known. I guess the battle for the OD Championship continues then, huh? We'll be right back, folks. Don't go anywhere.
Select the one to fight with. Get it wrong. 10-9-8-7-6. Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Yeah. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6.
Yes, sir.
Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. It's time for you to get into the character. You hit a loser, hit a win. I'm only asking you. Either you beat them or you beat them like
like an amateur. Either you drive or you get driven like a passenger. The fight's around the corner, so pick the one you want to. Represent your way, go head to head with your opponent. Feel it in the air, tension is electric. The glory's imminent, this is something epic. Miss for one of you, so what you gonna do? When your enemy is standing right in front of you, are you gonna lose, or are you gonna prove? To everyone that never thought you win, that you could rule. Cause everything is in your hands, you control it. And everything that is the past, it is over. This is now, this is everything that is. So you better make the right pick. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And just like a thief in the night, little Caesar attacks Esther from behind, moving the hole. Be careful what you wish for, going through. And ladies and gentlemen, this right here is the definition of hard subject to change, because this match wasn't supposed to go until later. But on one hand, I am a little happy about this, because it means that we get to the action much sooner than anticipated. Anything can happen in the world of AEW, and that right there is proven. I'm a brand spanking new referee, Jussei Arafat, vote for the bell, and we get to the runway. Ooh, nasty clothesline by Narcisa through all tips, trying to regain the momentum, but Tetsu cuts him off with that vertical super kick to another 90 right there. Tetsu stumping into a little deeper with a deadlift release suplex right there. Ever discount the power of Tetsu. Ooh! Nice quick right there by Narcisa. Tetsu turns the counter with an elbow shot. No avail. Narcisa catches Tetsu over the... Ooh! Nasty Russian leg sweep. Proving once again that even the Emperor likes to be one of those. Yes, that was for you, Jimmy. Oh, look at that. I'm raking the eye of that. It's illegal in these kind of matches. Oh, a nasty vertical choke is there in the feet. And now, ooh, nice counter into a back body drop by Petro right there. And now, yeah, right there, four-ounce match by Petro. And Petro touches him to the corner. And he's going to, oh, that was amazing. Oh, boy. Now, little sees that they get ready to the, oh, hot shot right there. And that will not do Petro dog throw anything. Elbow to the back of Petro's head by oh, good match. Now she's continuing the pressure right there. Picks up Petro, and here we go with that. Oh, pattern set. Vintage little Caesar with that backbreaker and a pressure fly to the lower back. Now Petro trying to get up on his own. Oh, nice catch. And a forearm shot to the face. And a kick to the left of the good measure. But Caesar retaliates and touches him to the corner. That always makes it great right there, rubbing the forehead into the long, thinly padded ropes right there. And oh, just touches him nonchalantly, mercilessly into the unforgiving steel of the cane. Now Caesar, ooh, he was trying to go for a European double dump. Oh, he did not know. Courtesy of Tetsu. Now Tetsu picks him up, and here we go with a. Ooh, nasty follow-up slam with some stall, demonstrating that power. Like I said, don't discount Tetsu because of his size. He could deliver some serious damage. And so, Caesar will demonstrate it with that flat, that other flapjack. Now, Caesar goes into the rope, and here we go with another flapjack. Of the total variety. Now, here we go with another toss to the rope, and are we going for corners, little Caesar? Are we going for corners? Perhaps we might. He pushes them to the other rope, and yes, folks, we went for corners. Little Caesar went for each and every one of those ropes at all. Wait a minute. Four corners was enough. Oh, boy. I see what he was doing. He was trying to weaken. He was trying to weaken on Petro for his own. Oh, that's what he's going to do. Oh, 26 expert. What is he? ESPR, I mean, where is the ESPR connect? And he's sitting over the air, we're going to see it, we're going to see it. No, instead he catches him with a neck breaker. And oh, he's over the first one, two, oh, two, ladies and gentlemen, two. That was one hell of a comeback right there by Tetsu. Now he's going to try to continue with that momentum, picking up. Ooh, nice shot. Ooh, and another lariat. Ooh, gets up with it. And, oh, power slam with a karate right there from Tetsu Shima. Two little Caesar. Now Tetsu picking up. Caesar putting him in the middle of the ring. And he hits it. Oh, and he got a head. And everybody knows that. Everybody knows that. Oh, right there. Put him with. Oh, a dumping elbow shot. Oh, we can see it. And again, he picks us out. Instead of using the Akira effect for our next victory, we're one, two, and again, two. And I'm willing to bet that he's regretting it now instead. Thinking he should have used the Akira effect. But I think he still got it. He thinks he got it in the back. Ooh, little Caesar Smith and see other ones. Is this going to be the neck breaker? Yes, it is. Neck breaker. And wrenching the spine. Little Caesar. Now Caesar continuing the pressure right there. Ooh, elbow to the face. Now Caesar picking off it. Okay. I see evil intentions in there. Ooh. Like I said, evil intentions in there. Ooh, right his shoulder through the corner right there. Tetsu trying to mount the combat, but then Caesar cuts him up right at the top. Ooh, he's going to run it. Oh, I'm going to see it. Pizza gonna spar into the head of Tetsu, and now it's time for Little Caesar to pick up, and he's got one, two, and oh, how close was Little Caesar to get the victory tonight, folks. Now Little Caesar, cool, calm, collected. He thinks he's got this one in the bag, and for all intents and purposes, he might. And we're gonna see it again. Are we? Yes, we are, folks. Pizza. a visa. Visa, visa, the next strike there hard for a second time. And first of the guy, he's going to go for a pin. One, two. And this guy, he's going to get a little visa. But what is that? And secure his bag as the one true contender for the Ruckus social media title. And bear in mind, ladies and gentlemen, that this match was stipulated like this as a punishment to Little Caesar for his actions on the last episode where he decided to act as no loser. And this whole cage thing came about to prevent this fellow member from having to interfere yet again. And hence the irony of it all, he won this match without any interference, without any help. Central gets a great fight, but in the end, as the irony struck Ed, he's the one, and now he's the number one contender for the CAWmbat Wrestling social media championship. As I said earlier, currently held by Eddie Rock. Good old Little Caesar.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's your winner, Little Caesar.
We got more excitement, real, and action-packed action coming your way in a few minutes. With the first match of the second round of the tournament of day coming right on the way. Oh boy, now I definitely can't wait to do that tag match. Along with this tournament of things, second round qualifying match coming up right after this match against Great of Running West Quibbly.
Part of the second round of the tournament of fate, and it is like the one to fall on the way. Oh, nah.
Know that one of the big favorites in this whole tournament. But will she be able to prove her support of the fight? Or will she be defeated and forced to watch her dreams and aspirations crumble right at her claws? And her opponent tonight is none other than the internet's babe, Bobcat Babe, who no doubt wants to keep this momentum in her short, yet very already illustrious career going strong. And no doubt they feature back-to-back in two mega events would definitely do that, huh?
And her opponent, from the scummy slums, Spanky Bobcat.
However, as we all know, one thing is aspirations, and another one completely different is actually making it there. And the roadblock she got facing tonight for such aspirations is a big one. I mean, she's already shown that she has all the tools and the skill, and plus being personally trained by the great Ronald McDonald self-help, but that's still no guarantee for victory. Or is it? Only one way to find out, and we all know what that is. No, folks. First match of the second round of the Tournament of Things will begin when our brand new referee, Jussei Arafat, calls for the bell, which is right now. As we all can witness, Damona trying to exert her superior strength for the early going, but Spanky utilizes his cunning of her own to counter that. Now Spanky tossing Damona real hard into that corner. Now turns around and tosses her through the rope, and ooh, catches her on the rebound with a nasty knee to the gut. Now Spanky goes behind it. Ooh, German sickness. And yes, Spanky is one of the few teams in the division strong enough to pull a German suplex with someone as big and as heavy as a man. And think of the morning. Ooh, nasty retaliation there with that arm from the Spanky mounting a comeback with that forearm to the back. And now Russian leg sweep. Demonstrated that even an infinite save, Bobcat Bay can do one of those. Yes, TV Dangerous Lee, I still keep up with you because you know we love you here at CAWmbat Wrestling. And we're waiting for your call. Now, Spanky. Oh, nasty snap T-bone to the moment right there. And trying to keep the momentum going, but he gets cut short with that back body drop. Now, Damona seizing the opportunity and, ooh, clubby blows to the back and Spanky coming into the trigger and dropping it. And trying to rally the crowd to her call. Damona trying to make it back to a vertical base and, ooh, Spanky uses his chance. And clothesline is right out of the rope. He's gonna go aerial. Rope-wise, this does not look good at all. Ooh, elbow, but that misses the mark by a mile. And Damona demonstrating her power again. And Spanky demonstrating her cunning yet again. Elbow shot to the Damona's face by Spanky. And another one. And ooh, fast out of it. Those hard knees. And ooh, first minute of the night. What? No, only from the count of one. And now Spanky continuing the pressure. Oh, that cringe ass move. And followed with a field goal to the vertebrae of Damona. Now, oh boy. The cringe continues, I guess. Oh, which one are red? Which one are red? Oh, God in heaven. Well, I guess it's pretty necessary with a woman as big and as heavy as Damona. You gotta do what you gotta do, right? And that's exactly what Spanky is doing. Tossing Damona through the rope. Oh, I'm gonna see it! I'm gonna see it! No relief! No relief for that card into the facial features and the check on Damona. And now we're going for another pick. Referee, user of a ticket for over here. One, two, two. Spanky, rightfully complaining because. But then again, it might be a rookie mistake. I mean, Mr. Arafat's brand new. We're gonna give him some music. Oh, and while I was saying that, Damona connects a hard sidewalk slam, and now she's roaring through the air, trying to gather some strength. Oh, Mr. Arafat, come on, you cannot allow this to happen. The first time was a rookie mistake, but this right here, that's a good thing. Now Damona tossing off. Spanky through the rope, oh, continuing the pressure right through the back, stalking and striking like a rapacious predator. And the punishment continues on behalf of Damona with that old claw through the trapezium. That's not gonna do her on right arm any favors. That would attract a lot of stress to get off. Now, now she's running on the comeback. And she will, gone wrong. Signature maneuver. And now she picks up Ramona. And, Ramona still got plenty left in the tank. Throw cross, kick. And that gets caught into a sweep. And now, single leg crack. Is the Mona gonna tap? Who's the gargoyle? Give it up? No, she knows how far she's gone, and she's not gonna give up so easy, I believe. Oh, another knee to the gut, hard, with those luscious yet secretly and ironically strong legs of Banky. Now Banky picking her up, and I don't think she wants to get hot shotted again like she was in the early. Now punches to the face, and a chop. This is the great Vic 16-time world champion with her. Backbreaker, imposing that strength of her. And here normally I would be complaining about the Mona not continuing the punishment, but after the punishment that she's gone through on her own, it's kind of exclusive. But look at that. She's still demonstrating that she's still got plenty left in the tank with 5 points. But still, as you can see, the Mona is visibly hurt. Banky manages to escape that that leg attack, and Finley by the floor, plus body slam, not a good combination, and neither is that clothesline. Was it a lariat? I can never tell. Now, Banky kicks her to the gut, and she goes back into the ring because she wants to win this the proper way. I thought it was a move. Showing with that sidewalk slam. And continue the pressure with that kick. And speaking of shades up, here we go. The Mona doing the shape of the great Miro from AEW with a little game over. But that's not the case for Banky. Not yet, I guess. Banky picks her up. And here we go with that inverted suplex. Banky picking up the Mona. And, going wrong for the second time in the night. Now she picks up the Mona, and I guess it's time to go for it again. I guess we are going to see it. No relief. Second one of the night. Will this be the final of the night? Let's find out. Referee, this time he's in position. One, two, and, two, ladies and gentlemen, two. And this time there are no excuses. Right place, right time, but the Mona will not give up. Now the Mona catches the kick, and followed with a dragon screw leg whip. And now Banky returns the receipt with a dragon screw leg whip up her own. Now the Mona catches up and does for our second one. Repeat the move for the win. And she caught up with that one particular kick this time. Now the Mona dragging Banky to position it. That's being unlimited. First signature maneuver. And most of the time when that hit, you know it's the end. Although this time the Mona wants to continue pressure, and that would not, I don't think that might have been a good idea. But that might be that sandbagging, utilizing her superior weight and strength yet again. Now the Mona stalking her prey. Now she picks her up, and some clubby blows, a kick, and that gets caught, and another sweep, and another ziggler buster crack. Well, this won't be the one that makes her tap. Nope. She gets out of this one much quicker than she did before. Now the Mona continuing those kicks to the lower back and continuing the pressure to set lower back and back it. And now she's going for a standard combo clutch. And look at that. Look at that. So close to the rope. Just to tease her, but Banky, there's plenty of energy left in her tank. And the Mona is trying to wear her out with that. I think she was going to go for 1,000 year curse, but Banky read that telegram and fell out of town. Face to the apron. That doesn't do those lovely pictures of her. Baby, I'm not even now. Now, the Mona picked her up and, another spine off to the thoracic. And just like carries her around like a rag doll. You know, imposing herself, and here we go. The gargoyle dies, the other signature maneuver, and is she gonna go for it again? No. She's just letting her on so this to take over, and that's not a good idea. I'm sorry. None of this. I was gonna say nothing is is that for maybe? Are we gonna see it? Stomping here, turn. With every single one of those pounds falling into the Muna, will this be it? Will she move on to the next round? One, two, no, two to the two, ladies and gentlemen. Now the Muna keeping on it, and here we go with another. Oh, that's the unlimited. And now she keeps the pressure, rightfully so, because if all the stuff that she's done has not taken out of Michael, she's gonna have to pull on all cylinders. And I guess she hurt because now she's hitting that man, that cloth for the Trapeze Megan. And this time, Frankie had enough of that and she tripped on the motor off her. So Frankie going to, outrider, nope. Powerbomb, upset elbow higher with strength. Now she's calling out the troops. She's trying to gather some strength, but speaking of strength, look at that. Look at it just tossing off. Frankie like a bag doll, the moment. And third, fourth, I don't know how many this is in the. And here we go with another fire in the tank. One, two, and ooh, how low was that? 2 7/10. Now, the Muna picking up Spanky. And Spanky, aware of the situation, getting behind. And here we go with another hard-hitting German. But you can noticeably see the Spanky is getting worn out there. Now she's continuing the pressure, or at least trying to, controlling the head of the Muna. And now she's gonna go for a deflect perhaps. But no, the Muna read that telegram and cut it off itself. And oh boy, look at the strength. Look at the power. Look at the sheer. Oh, crap. Oh, did you see how her face landed on whiplash? Oh, that does not look good. Oh boy. The Muna's gonna go for it again. 1,000-year curse! And that combined with the way her face caught the rope, that might be it. 1, 2, and yes, folks, that was it. The Muna advances to the next round of the tournament of day. And give credit to whom credit is due. I think the Muna must have had the fight of her life in this very round, in this very match. Thank you, thank you. Was taken to a limit that I don't think Jesus has much taken before and might not be taken again, who knows? But right there, the Muna proved with power, with speed, and with sagaciousness why she is one of the handsome favorites to win this one. And the fact that Frankie landed the way she landed from that Corita press, you know, I think we should call the doctor because she landed really, really bad from that. Anyway, congratulations on the Muna. We'll move it on to the next round of the tournament of day. So seriously, can we get the doctor to go check if Frankie's doing okay there, please?
This gentleman is your winner, the Muna.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a lot more show going on. There's 3 more matches on the tournament of day coming right up. And the Muna becomes the first one to advance to the next round, which is maximum victory against Banky Fox. And speaking of the tournament, the next match comes out next, right after the game. Don't go anywhere, everybody. We'll do it with more CAWmbat Wrestling.
So let's get move! Tip to the wall, yo, here we go, I don't want it all. 生まれたばっかりの旅人、慣れない足取りもまた愛嬌、決めるとこだけバシッと。So many people in this world 時に抽象とかうまいわけじゃないけどつまんないとこはワープしてこう筋だけは通し生きてるザ・タウロー待てのないテイプオンウェイジでフィールソーレッツゴーぶっ飛び続け見つ してるよ Go 愛し愛時代に感じ愛さまざまなドラマ作ってこう So many things we wanna try Pop song の底に隠れてるリスタイル50億の願い Lose my crowd きっと誰かに届くよ Why
息さえつけない眠れない街隙も見せずに笑い当て嘘さえセーフティー
Let's get moving!
It's moving to the fire wire Let's dive into the fire deep 広い世界に怯えてる始まったばかりのナビゴフスキー and ファキビきっと輝くアラナは誰かに届くまで力強くファイリン未来を描く地図もない愛だって恋だってマジに出会いたいよいたたんと
They don't thank you condition, despite the whiplash effect, there's no ill effect, so that's a relief, part of the fun. And we shall get back to the action, back to action, of the tournament of days, from thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following country is taken to one fall, and it is for the second round of the tournament of days. On the Wizard Ring, residing in Gotham City, Harley Quinn.
The one and only, the pride of the Joker, one of the most sadistic and malicious yet most killed individuals in the entire Dave roster. What must be so close to the Dane's closest location? And that's what she's going to buy for a third time. But in order to get there, she must defeat her opponent tonight at a match for the next round. And that might be easier said than done when it comes to this. Right here.
And her opponent, from Ottawa, Canada, the Thunder Force, Simmons.
After an astounding performance of the first round, she aims to advance. It was perhaps be the highest profile match of her show career here at CAWmbat Wrestling against a veteran of the sport like Harley Quinn. Will she make it or will Harley bring down her structure? The second match of the second round. How will it end? We will find out as soon as our new referee Jussei Arafat rings the bell with this right now. And we begin this match with a nice basic lockup, which Harley Quinn wins over and now she goes behind Tennis and goes for that rear bear hug. Tennis now counters with a nice takedown and a headlock of her own and ooh, driving the knee right to the back of Harley. Another lockup and now she's dragging on Tennis into the corner. And referee Jussei Arafat knows that she has to break that up. And he does. And surprisingly, Harley didn't Wow! We just begun again and now we got our first mistake going on. Oh man, that was funny. Now Seth is gonna go for a duplex. Harley Quinn is gonna duplex on her own. And a clubby blow for good measure. Now Harley going for a suplex and with everything going down. They're putting a little bit of power in there. Never underestimate the flight of Joker, folks. Just as insane and as skilled as her husband, just so you know. But Tennis is no slouch in the second of the final. Shown there by that, takedown. A forearm takedown right there by Tennis. And now, Harley trying to make a comeback with that fireman takedown on the kneeling variety. And now, nice payback by the Commander Tennis proper with that nasty foot of the client right there. Now, Tennis is under pressure. Ooh, forearm to the jaw of Harley Quinn. Now, with the Commander Crawford picks her up and ooh, Harley makes her pay with a nasty sort of clothesline. Now, Harley picks up Commander Crawford and ooh, nasty faraway slam. Basic as it is painful. Now, it's Harley who's trying to get some momentum. And she has an elbow to the upper chest of Commander Crawford. Ooh, counters that with that Arm and drag of her own, and an NCBD. Now she's rallying the troops to her, of course, right there. Commander Tennis Crawford. Ali gets back on a vertical basis. Ooh, forearm to the face. And I don't think that was a good idea for Commander Crawford to taunt all over the place, because now Harley's gonna put a smile on her face. And now she's feeling the momentum just between her face. Now she's going aerial. Harley Quinn is. Is she gonna connect this? Let's find out. Ooh, inverted a coffin drop. Almost chased over AEW Saudi Island, and I don't think that's out of one and 9/10 there. Harley picks her up and ooh, another arm drag courtesy of Commander Dennis Crawford here. Is she gonna go? No, I think she was gonna go for just a short foul driver, but that got countered rather quick. And now Harley is signaling. Are we gonna see it? Yes, we are. Harley winning. Harley winning, putting power into the feature of Commander Phoenix Crawford. Now she gets back center of the ring, and here we go. She's in a bad position. 1, 2. And this one ended as quick as it began. Harley Quinn advances to the next round of the tournament. Update. Giving tons of credit to Commander Simmons Ruffle for making it this far, and even more so for putting such an amazing performance. But in the end, I think the veteran skills of Harley Quinn were far too much to surpass. And she finally makes it so that she could once again say Madea Simmons is if he becomes the last person to win this whole tournament. But that's a big if, considering all the other contenders in this tournament of days. And you know what I mean. With the mana already confirmed, and two more on the way.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Harley Quinn.
Two down, two to go. More of the tournament of days, as well as more of CAWmbat Wrestling from your way. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back. Everybody knows that this guy is nothing to screw with. This guy is pure evil, pure power, pure malevolent, and I don't think anybody is safe in here. I think he wants to talk, and whether we like it or not, we're gonna have to listen. Not like we have a choice.
I'm petrified out of my mind. I'm not gonna lie. Let's see what I'm saying. I think we had a choice. That challenge made that someone accepts the challenge to step in and tangle with this beast, and that someone is none other than Bedrock, the strongest man in the modern Sony, the pride of the rubble, the man, the myth, the compulsive powerhouse. And ladies and gentlemen, this guy being who he is, it's gonna be nasty in there. Don't expect a technical show. Expect a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. On the way to the ring, the opponent from Bedrock in the Stone Age, Bam Rubble.
This one here will be more akin to a nuclear submarine taking on a fully armored battleship. It's not gonna be pretty. It's not gonna be nice. There might be some technical prowess here and there. But this is two bulls of battle. Nah, forget bulls. These are two bull elephants about to clash in tonight. And Bandon wants to be the one who stops the path of oblivion before it starts. Will he do it? Or will he become the first victim to Onslaught's Reign of Terror? We'll find out in about a few seconds. The challenge has been laid. The combatants are set. Referee, you say it up and wait for the bell, and this one gets on the way. And here we go. We got Bam Bam trying to enforce his strength on Eddie going, but ooh, nice sandbagging by Onslaught, stopping him dead in his tracks, and ooh, knee to the face. And that padding will definitely not do Bam Bam's face any favors. Oh boy! Oh, look at that! Look at that! Look, Onslaught just tossing Bam Bam around like a rag doll, and mind you, Bam Bam is a 6'6". 300-plus-pound individual. This not more fry at all. Now Onslaught applying those evil elbows to the face of Bam Bam. He just wants to do away with Bam Bam as soon as possible, I guess. Now, ooh, nice flip down by Bam Bam. Trying to follow it up with a kick to the back, but that doesn't happen. Oh, nasty German there by Onslaught. Continuing the pressure there. Now Onslaught picking up Bam Bam, and Bam Bam picks him down. Showing a little strength, he's gonna have to out-wrestle Onslaught instead of out-powering if he wants to get anywhere with him. That's just my advice. Now Bam Bam dragging Onslaught to the center of the ring, and he's going for, ooh, gut wrench into a suplex. See, this is why he's known as Bedrock's strongest. I mean, look at the strength he has to use for this beast of a man. Beast of a being, and now also we compare with that suplex or that vertical variety. Ooh, nice shot there. Oh, he was trying to follow with a crossbody, but that didn't happen. Now Bam Bam's gonna try to keep going with the momentum with a brainbuster. Nice and nasty, all of the things that, oh, look at him raking the eyes like he's needed. Now, there we go with his signature maneuver. Bring destruction right there. And now, ooh, nice clothesline by Bam Bam, and he was always that top one, two, and I was about to say, Bam Bam is world famous for those clotheslines and lariats that he makes. Those people are stiff as it gets. And so was that stiff running clothesline by Onslaught. Demonstrating that in terms of power, you don't want a man with Onslaught in terms of power. And look at this malicious attack. And why is referee Jussei Arafat not doing anything? You know why? I know why. Because you wouldn't want to mess with a dude that big. Oh, nice clip up by Oh, there we go. Yabba dabba doo connects right into Onslaught. He completely no-sells it. That's how powerful and dangerous Onslaught is. You know, under other circumstances, I will be talking crap, but this is Onslaught we're talking about. So, yeah. Now Onslaught tossing up Bam Bam to the outside. Oh, no. Oh, into the outside. Rise,
And I must agree with everybody in the combat arena. This is indeed an impact awesome. Also now, Tustin Bam Bam back in the ring, trying to continue to impose as well. Oh, another stiff clothesline by the Dark One, by the Being of Devastation. And oh, nice counter into that shuffle kick, and a stiff clothesline of his own by Bam Bam Bam. Oh, he's, how do you call it, bubbling up, Bam running up, whatever. All I know is that he's powering up, and he wants to finish. Oh, nice counter by Oslo. And Bam Bam retaliates into the other side of the ring. Just stuck in here. That's not a good idea, Bam Bam. You should keep at it. You should keep at him. And again, trying to outpower him. And again, that was and now, Oslo going for that nasty vertical good luck on that thinly padded floor. I can never stop stressing how thinly padded that thing is. And oh, face first into the turnbuckle. Courtesy of Onslaught, who proceeds to pick Bam Bam up, and now Bam Bam's the one who retaliates by tossing Onslaught into the ring and kicking him for good measure. Onslaught gets back up, and oh boy, he catches a power body slam for his trouble. Now Bam Bam picks him from the head, and oh, touches him back down, crashing down it. And I don't see Bam Bam doing aerial maneuvers often. Will this pay up? It actually does! Nice moonsault, by the way. And now, roughly you said, I'm like, look, only for the count of one. Hey, you got, hey, this is also what we're talking about, so yeah, you might want to exactly do that. Yeah, we're going to do it for the second time in a row here. Now he picks up on the, oh, knee to the face. And, oh, another gut wrench on suplex, or maybe something else, let's see. Get another gut wrench suplex. Yes, folks, Bam Bam is picking up business here, and he looks like he's going to toss Onslaught hard into the rope. That that moment that cut short, and oh, belly to belly across the rope like he's a rat. Now Onslaught give an indication that this is gonna be finishing up, and oh, are we gonna see it again? Oh, actually no, Bam Bam gets away from it, and oh, this time he's gonna get a crossbody block. Now Bam Bam picking up Onslaught. And oh, that Yabba Dabba do on the night. That's a new strategy. Let him have it from the get-go. And one, two, no, legitimate two to the two. I thought the path to obliteration was going to be ended before it started. But yeah, no. You're going to have to keep going. Now we go with, ooh, touch with a total flapjack. Now he touches it to the south or southern corner. Another crossover flapjack. I've been going for corners. You don't know if Little Caesar do this earlier. Here we go with a third crossover flapjack. But then again, when you cross over a guy that big, then you gotta be impressed. You just gotta be impressed. Oh, he was trying to follow it up, but Onslaught this time, he read the telegram, he got out of it. Ooh, power slam with a forest right there. By the Being of Devastation, the Destroyer, the Eraser of Multiverses. Now here we go, clothesline, shoulder tackle, turns it into the corner, ooh, hip smashing, cross body of his own, courtesy of Onslaught. Now Onslaught picking up Bam Bam, and oh, I think, oh, it's even worse. Here we go, Ian Shockwave connects right there. Here we go, one, two, and only two, the count of two, ladies and gentlemen. You gotta give all props in the universe to Bam Bam for handling this malevolent bait the way he is. Now Onslaught was going to the head of Bam Bam right there. And right there, he tosses him to the corner hard. Ooh, he was going to go for a back rope into that corner. And oh boy, he's going to go for a, ooh, butterfly backbreaker. Picking up that 7+ footer. Oh boy, are we going to see it, ladies and gentlemen? Are we going to see it? Oh, Onslaught caught it in the time. And oh, he catches him with a kill that of his own. He completely prevented left in the rubble. And now Bam Bam makes a save with that nasty shoulder tackle. I think we might see it again. Hey, this thing for that left in the rubble. Left in the rubble with everything. And he's going to pin her. One, two, and oh, how close was that? How close was that? Sorry, Bam Bam. Don't waste your time on a complaint for the ref. He did a good call there. this is what you should do. Oh, he was going to go for a nothing to rope again, but that's where the ground got red. And ooh, Hunter with a nasty power body slam. Now, Old Dog is going to try to go with this. Oh, this is going to be ugly. This is going to be nasty. Oh, and five and a break the mighty hand. Expertly. And mind you, he's not been out here for a while. He's getting those terrible maneuvers. This is my gift from this young man. I'm telling you, there's a bright future ahead for Bam Bam Rubble in this business. I'm calling it right now. Now he picks up Ozma and also gets away from that one. Ooh, the retaliation by Bam Bam and Rubble back to the ring. Bam Bam going behind Ozma, but Ozma goes behind on his own. And ooh, probably blows. It's like getting hit with a steel bar. Ooh, another vertical suplex. And also, yet again, falls for the end. Now, Bam Bam trying to get... Oh, that was... That hip into the face. That must not feel good at all. Now, also facing, picking up Bam Bam. And, ooh, nice evasion by Bam Bam right there. Now, look at that strength of Bam Bam picking that 7 foot, almost 400 pound giant into a military press. And now Bam Bam pick him up and ooh, clothesline. He dodges that clothesline and oh, back body drop it. What is he gonna do now? What else? Spine buster with a hurricane. And now I think he's gonna go for another Yabba-dabba-doo perhaps. No, I think he changed his mind. He shouldn't be taking so long. Ooh, diving the head into the chest of Onslow, but that didn't seem to do much. As he spit with a spinning power slam by Onslow right there. Now Onslow dragging him like a dead target, and here we go again with the monster punch. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. He just, yep. From where I could see, yep, he busted him wide open. It's official, ladies and gentlemen, Bam Bam Rubble is busted open. Now Onslow picking up Bam Bam, and Bam Bam retaliates with a back that he comes to the zone. Bam Bam, I think he's on block. And pardon the language, it hit. Bam Bam, it hit. But Onslow doesn't seem to care about that. Now, look at that. Look at how he just nonchalantly enters the frame like nothing ever happened. And now he's going for a stupid shoot that's on the zone. And oh boy. Oh boy, evil intentions. Are we going to see it? The mighty hand! The mighty hand crushing Bam Bam to show, and here we go, 1, 2, and yet goes the first victim with a fast obliteration in Bam Bam Rubble. Jeez almighty, what a match. Just like the calling was going to be, just as it was. Bam Bam will left, right, front, and center, trying to impose his will and his power over. But sadly, in the end, Onslow prevailed and added his first victim, his first sacrifice. But give Bam Bam all the credit in the multiverse for pulling this and going all out. Even though in the end he didn't do much to stop the mighty being, the eraser of multiverse, but it was pretty close. Let's not deny it, it was pretty close. Anyway, congratulations to Onslow.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner,
Onslow. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back with more action-packed action this time. We're thrilled up to this. Go anywhere, we'll be right back. And I'm going to have to go to the back for a minute because I'm going to get myself off. Whoa! New pair of undies. I'll be looking right back. One of the very basic process is a necessary reminder that the seven and a half day is right after this. Don't go anywhere, do it right back.
sucks!
Sorry about that, folks. I was just putting my earphones back. Welcome back to CAWmbat Wrestling and to the second round of the Tournament of Days. Ladies and gents.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is part of the second round of the tournament today. On the way to the ring, from the next installation in Amarillo, Texas,
That supermarket supremacist makes it here into the second round of the tournament of days. And let's call a spade a spade. If you weren't for the interference of hockey on the first round, you would not be here. But as we know, there will be no one to help her out. So will she be able to do it on her own? Or will she succumb to her opponent tonight, who happens to be none other than La Belle Assassine, who many have also predicted to be a very all-around favorite to win this whole tournament, and face Madea Simmons for the CAWmbat Wrestling Dave Champion. But as we all know, one thing is prognosis, and one thing is actually making it there. So let's see if we can do that.
Fighting in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, I believe they're
afraid. I mean, don't any of you get me wrong, ladies and gentlemen. She has shown time and again that she has the tools and the skills necessary to make it that far into the tournament. But one thing is the tools and the skills, and one thing is the implementation. Especially with someone as violent, as aggressive, and as cruel and mischievous as the F. Will she be able to see the world? Lady X will be able to pull an offset and take down La Belle Assassine. Here's the moment to find out, and as we all know, with my wife. Am I right, folks? Oh, come on. You know I am. Stage set. Combatants ready. Referee Jussei Arafat, ring for the bell, and here we go. We begin this battle with a little round of study between these two dames, and Lady X pushes Abilene to the corner, and are we gonna have another glitch like earlier? I really hope not. I don't need the problem. Like, ooh, you know, God, nice kick to the gut by Lady X with something different. Provided with a bump of the night. But Matthew, I know your channel is down for a bit, but this was not for you. Nice sandbagging there by Abilene, but that didn't do much. Lady X continued the pressure. Ooh, nice forearm by Abilene. Abilene tosses Lady X to the outside and pulls her right back in. Abilene, ooh, field goal kick to the back of Lady X. Good process to retaliate with a nasty clothesline to the corner. And yup, goes Abilene. Courtesy of Lady X, who proceeds to pick Abilene up, and ooh, another forearm shot to the face, and another right hand. I think Abilene had enough of that, and she took one of her own, and ooh, follows it up with a single leg drop kick. Abilene trying to pick up Lady X, but ooh, that momentum gets it. Ooh, nice shoulder tackle by Lady X. Didn't think she had it in her. And now she just rolls all Abilene, and ooh, that's a sadistic, cruel trick that I was talking about, and here we go with that move that we prefer to follow right here. How the hell is this legal still? Ooh, nice drop up to the head by Lady X to Abilene. Now Lady X picks Abilene up, and ooh, another snapmare. Oh, the heel to the face. Look at this disrespect. Make it sick.
Now he's got one, two, only for the camera. Two, ladies and gentlemen, two to the two. I'm sorry, I got so drunk with it, but I just make it sick. And oh boy, oh boy. Are we going to see it? I guess we are. Expiration day. Expiration day, Cornette. I think she wants to break Hardy's record and make this match even shorter. He was one, two, and oh, almost one. That's why. Yeah, because let's face it, Hardy's match earlier on in the show was a little on the short side. Here we go with another leg up, and again, another bad one. This was definitely for the book of Bunchamania. If I Bunchamania doesn't cover CAWRL, this would have been it. The hustle is trying to go for it, and she hits it. She hits the, and she hits the hip across the face of Lady Hill. Uh-oh. Aveline calling up for her own shot. Are we going to see it? Are we? Ooh, connect. And she was going to go for the cross and to the liberation, but that gets you, baby. And she just profaned to the outside door of trouble. Aveline is courtesy of Lady Egg, who proceeds to punish her on that thinly padded floor. And again, I never get tired of stretching how that this floor down here is. And now Lady X dragging Aveline to the barricade. And she just slams her head through the barricade. And now she just tosses her to the other side of the floor and here goes the car loose. Rather than following up, she uses the car. That's gonna come back to bite her in the ample lucky studio for Brazilian surgically repaired studio. Now, Aveline doesn't bring Lady X back into the ring. And she proceeds to pay in a hero one. Nope. Only for the camera. Aveline trying to go for another field goal, but that gets caught. Now, smack into the back of Aveline. Proceeded with the expiration date out of nowhere. Practically out of nowhere. And now, hero for the pin. One, two, and legitimate. The two for the two. Stance in this one, and now Lady X is just proceeding to complain, and oh boy, I think she wants to go for a third one. She wants to go for a third one, but that one got bad. I think it's good. I've been inside. Ooh, nice jumping tornado DDT by Aveline, demonstrating the aerial skill that she's so famous for. Aveline pursuing after Lady X, and ooh, elbow to the face, tossing her down the apron. Now she picks up Lady X. Good boy. I see evil intentions going on in the mind of Aveline. Ooh, puts her in the barricade. And suplex to the barricade. And couple of shots. And oh boy. I know this maneuver all too well. Well, let's call it, everybody. Aveline. And oh, dropping the leg into the back of the neck of our Lady X. And I gotta agree with the folks in the combat arena, folks. This one is awesome. Aveline prepping to hit Lady X with her own. Are we gonna see it? Are we? The kick connects. The legs across. I think we are gonna see it. Liberation. Liberation connects right there. He goes, one, two, and two, ladies and gentlemen. Due to the due. So close and yet so far. And still Aveline is calling for the troops. She feels this one in the bag. And now Aveline is the one wrenching the head of Lady X in that move that we effectively call, how is this still leaving? Now Aveline picks Lady X up, pushes her to the corner. And she gets countered. Ooh, the knee to the face of Lady X, she makes her get up and drop stick right there. And oh boy, Lady X going to the corner, not a good idea. Ooh, four on to the face. Oh, she was going to go for a hit, but Lady X got out of there in the nick of time. And now she's going for a neck breaker. Nope, that got evaded. And ooh, knee to the face for her trouble. Aveline takes Lady X. Ooh, making up the ball, which is also known as a Falcon Arrow, but because I had a lot of complaints of people telling me, I have to address it, I'm sorry. Now, Lady X picking up Aveline, and oh, that did not go at, oh, she got it, that's not the slut. Lady X is going to tap, she does, Lady X tapped out the slut, Aveline from here, moves to the next round of the tournament of day.
And I gotta give props to Lady X, because this time there was absolutely no help from anyone whatsoever. She did this on her own, but in the end, I believe she pulled all the stops, she went the extra mile, and she earned her spot in the next round of the tournament of May. That makes Raylan stay down with only one more to go. The one who makes it from the next match coming up. And out of these four, only one will meet and face Madea Simmons for the CAWmbat Wrestling Team Championship. But who will it be?
This is gonna be your winner.
As La Belle of the Sea passes in the glory of victory, one has to wonder, will she be the one to play for the Assembly Corners of the Wrestling Team Championship, or will she also fall in the next round of the tournament? All kinds of surprises are waiting for you. And more surprises coming up with the final match of the sixth round coming up after the next. Good one, you win. Right back.
To the final match of the second round of the tournament of the day here on CAWmbat Wrestling. And on what better note to end it than with the Empress of the Budokai herself? Am I right, everybody?
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is part of the second round of the tournament of the day. On the way to the ring, representing Hercules City, Son Hun.
Just like Harley Quinn, she was so close she could taste it. And now she wants that opportunity yet again. But will she be able to achieve it, or will she be cut short? That is the big question. But then again, that's the same question with everybody in the tournament.
not to quote Jim Cornette, who do you know who won the pony?
And her opponent, from the seas of Sequin Land, Ricky.
And I'm going to be real with you folks, my common sense from the way she won her ticket into this match. By literally stealing it from right under my Shiranui. And as far as I hear, Shiranui-sama is still quite sure about it. But let's just hope that she doesn't try to pull a Lashley and try to rule, right? But then again, that makes you see that Captain Boots is a wily, guile-filled, very sneaky individual. Don't take your eyes off of her. I mean, a lot of people will say, well, it's not cheating if the referee didn't touch you, but still, let's just hope that things go well and that we get a cleaner victory tonight. Whether it's she who wins or it's fun, let's just hope that things go better. So, the last thing is we need is more fun. Just saying. And now, the final match of the second round of the tournament of the day. Something is, we're referee set up back. Oh, what about? Both Danes going into a round of 30. Ooh, Pound wins this one. Going in behind Ricky Boots. Now Ricky doing a little go behind of her own. Squeezing the waist of Pound. Ooh, nice. Hit it by takedown. And now she's controlling the head. And a punch to the face of this match. Now, ooh, another clinch. Now she goes behind again. Ricky Boots and another takedown. And now she's controlling the wrist. Ooh, nice go behind of Pound's own. And she goes for a takedown of her own, and that's controlling the head of Ricky Wilson. Which one with this nice technical back and forth, and oh, she was gonna go for a neck breaker, but I got counter with that shoulder block. And now she's gonna squeeze on, oh no. Oh no, I know this. Like I said, I know that move. Oh man, it's great. Now Ricky Boots making her suffer with that kick to the gut. Oh, inverted blockbuster right there. Now, oh, Pound makes her pay with that clip. And a field goal to the lower back of Captain Boots there. Now she goes behind it. Oh, a couple of elbow shots to get her off herself. And Pound continues the pressure there with Chuck of her own. Oh, nice Frankensteiner there by Captain Boots. She's on. Now she picks Pound up, and oh, she was going for a running kick, but that didn't work. Now she goes for the, oh, nice counter there. Into a DDT by Pound to Ricky Boots. Oh, the Kamehameha going for an early goal. She wants to end this quick. She wants to break Arnie's record, I guess. One. No, only to the count of 1 and 9, 10. And yeah, it's a little squirrely for that Pound. Even though that Kamehameha always hurts no matter what. Now she gets stuck to the outside of Captain Bootstock, and Pound is running the crowd to her favor. And the countdown begins from the outside. Now Pound picking up Ricky Boots, and now Ricky countering with a forearm. Now she's gonna drag her to the barricade, I think. But Pound gets her off right in the nick of time. Now Pound on hot pursuit of Captain Boots, and ooh, nice evasion there. And now Captain Boots sees that the count has gone a little further than she wanted to. Ooh, hot shot by Pound. And you know, if Ricky Boots is gonna go like that, then I guess she's gonna go, ooh! Spinning with a nagi right there, demonstrated that power. Never underestimate a Pound for her size. She's got some power, like, hey, she's a Saiyan. You should know how that goes. Now she just, late, Captain Boots in the middle of the middle rope, and oh! That knee does not do any favors to the lower back. Oh, I think he was going to go for a spear bomb, but Captain Boots showed up from a mile down, and she did not want any of that. I can tell you right now. Now, ooh, nice invasion there by Ricky Boots. And, oh, she was going to go for a forearm, but that gets him in. Oh, and a nice shoulder block by Pond on that thinly padded floor. She was going to go for another shot to the gut, but that didn't work. Back at the third ring, and it, ooh, a Netflix slam on the shape of Ronald McDonald there. And mind you, she wasn't one of the ladies that was trained by the manager himself. So. But it is a good gesture, I guess. And no, you gotta be out of your mind. Are you gonna try to do that? Like,
Really? Okay, come with me, friend. It just ain't that was so control, rather physical. And it's a total wonder that Captain Book was able to recover from that. Oh, let's see her recover from that spinning kick down. Right, here we go. One, two, and two, ladies and gentlemen, two, two, the two. Now Pond continued to pressure as any good competitor should. And, oh boy, she's calling for it. She's calling for it. Are we gonna see it this time? I guess we are. The spirit ball connects hard, and here we go, one, two, and ladies and gentlemen, Sung Pond has won this match, and just concludes the second round for the tournament of days. This time, all the guile and all the wile did not help Captain Booth, even though she did a magnum display, I'm not gonna knock it, but in the end, Pond seems to have been more driven and more wanting of this new opportunity. And this concludes the second round of the tournament. All four participants are now picked and placed. And now we just gotta wait to the next round to see who finally makes it to the end. And a chance on Madea Simmons and the CAWmbat Wrestling Day Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Sean.
Ladies and gentlemen, the second round of the tournament of days might be over, but this show is not. In fact, we have a lot more to come. Coming right up. And as I was saying, we got this rock action coming up with this new Stephanie Day tag. Coming right up with it. Don't go anywhere, further. Then we'll know why this match came about. And on pain and perjury of something like I'm giving up my oath of objectivity, I gotta call it like it is. If Wendy did not have a D on her mouth like she did last episode, this wouldn't have come about. But Wendy is not one to be underestimated.
with, despite her salty and rapping tongue, she has more than enough skills to back it all up. And along with Annie Popeye, they are a force to contend with. Let's just hope that the Night Warriors are not too angry and can concentrate at the task at hand. Speak of the devil, literally this time, and in this sense, it's not a bad thing, right guys? And that comment also goes for a couple of you ladies out there, you know who you are. Whew, that reminds me, we are an LGBTQ+ Pride Month, so enjoy it with dignity, ladies and gents, you deserve it.
And their opponent, representing the Night Warriors, from Glasgow, Scotland, Morrigan and Lang.
As always, she walks on toward that aisle, toward that ring, forever proud, forever sure of herself. But something tells me that behind that lovely smile that she's giving us, just look at her. See? Saw that little pose right there? That is showing you a race that I haven't seen within her in quite a while. You know, right now she's giving us a show, like Joe does, like, this is it. I think the thing that Wendy said affects her. And that might play into the outcome. Quote me on that. Just do me a favor, quote me on that. In the meanwhile, let's just enjoy this intro from her. Enjoy that ethereal beauty that is the Empress of the Makai. But remember, there might be more behind that smile. So don't be surprised. Oh, speaking of surprises, oh, here comes my favorite part.
Felicia.
A performance worthy of the greatest dance, folks, I tell you. I love watching this dance, man. I love watching her dance. However, behind that happy-go-lucky attitude, I can tell that there's a fire, a rage building in her. And see it? You see it? Wait till she gets to the hard cam. You'll see it. You'll see what I mean. See it right there? It's hard for her to hide the rage, to contain the wrath that she has in her, and she just wants to put hands on Wendy and make her pay for what she said to her back in episode 3. This is gonna be emotional. This is gonna be personal. This is gonna be ugly. And this is gonna start right now. And we got Morrigan wasting no time trying to get some hands on Wendy's bun, but Wendy read that telegram and she's aiming to punish, not just with words, but with her fist, her feet, and everything else. Morrigan misses that dropkick, and now Wendy capitalizes. Ooh, an inspiration there by Morrigan, and now a kick of her own, and Clint, now she goes behind Morrigan, though, behind Wendy. Now she's squeezing the waist of Wendy, and full takedown there, and now she's locking in, controlling the head of Wendy Thomas right there. And I'm willing to bet she wants to rip her that head off so she can never stop again. Ooh, nice counter there by Wendy into a sister. And now, ooh, controlling the head again. And that's done. Now Wendy, ooh, lovely rocking there. Like I said, don't discount Wendy. Just by being a loudmouth, she could more than back it up. And now she attacks to Annie Popeye's head. Ooh, Annie gets a back body drop for his mouth. Now, even though she feels guilt by association, but Morrigan is not going to care. She's still going to punish her too, if need be. And so will Felicia, I believe. Oh, she misses that dropkick too, and Annie Papa capitalizes. And elbow to the knee. Now she throws Annie to her corner, and oh, I thought they were going to tag, but it's just a one-person truck over. That's cool. I'll let it go. I'll call. Now Morrigan picking up Annie. Oh! Ooh! Darkness vision from the early going. And now, ooh, Annie just, for some strange reason, she was able to no-sell the darkness vision. And Morrigan makes her pay with that willpower counter. I think she picked up a few extra moves from a few creators, I guess. Ooh, Morrigan touches her to the outside. And you're gonna pull her back in? Oh, she's gonna do something worse. Oh, boy. This is gonna suck. Oh,
Oh, did it into the apron.
I told you guys this was going to get personal, didn't I? Now, Annie Papa gets Morgan off herself. Ooh, a punch to the face. And Annie comes out with a elbow to the leg. And now she's continuing with that barrage. Nothing fancy, just going in. Much crazy right there. And now she tosses it. Oh, right just to the apron. Amina, she has such a nice upper chest. That's did I mention this is Pride Month now? No, but seriously, a happy Pride Month to all of you on the LGBTQ plus community. From here, from CAWmbat Wrestling, we wish you the best. Legitimate. Now coming back to the action back action. Morgan dragging Annie Popeyes to her corner. And now she picks her up and gonna throw it to the corner. And look, Felicia just wants in. She wants in. And, oh, there we go. She's in. And they toss to the woman. Oh! Spear and clothesline. That's a move that D'Angelo Cobain do off. I guess that's kind of a tribute to the man, you know? That's actually very hostile. I like that. That was actually cool. And this may not be as cool, but it's effective. Oh, diving with axe handle. And now Wendy's about to give Felicia what she wanted. And make sure, you know, give her that whole careful what you wish for kind of thing. Oh, I think Felicia read that telegram and got her off herself. Now Felicia, ooh, elbow to the jaw. And now Wendy, ooh, countered with an impale DDT right there. And Wendy getting the pressure. Oh, stiff heart clothesline. And knowing what we know, then yeah, you'll understand. It may not be the best thing, it may not be the most legal thing to be stiff on, yeah. Ooh, Rossi Boxler, right? Actually, that's a sand splash in my bad, folks. That's totally wrong. Sand splash kick. And that's just a virtual corner. Oh, this is the portion of the other. I thought we weren't going to have that, but this is the portion where we call the water trick. Now, if you excuse me. This good little Nikki, that's some good high quality as well. And this is some good ass match right here. We got one. Oh, Nikki, I don't want it. Yet another red ball. I thought we were not going to have another one, but oh, now I'm home again. Oh boy, this is going to suck. This is going to suck and it's going to go hard. Perpetual slumber. Signature maneuver, it's hard. And she picks her up because she wants the button for more. She wants her to suffer. She wants her to feel pain for the emotional distress that she has caused. And oh boy, what better way to cause pain than to plant her on the thinly padded floor, courtesy of that coast-to-coast DDT. And again, I may sound like a broken record. Bone to the thinly padded floor. And should I also say flesh? Never a good mix. And neither is flesh or steel. Oh, the Night Warriors really want to take it to Wendy, but I'm sorry, Wendy. I know I'm right here, and I know I'm so unobjective, but you brought this in yourself, Joe. I'm sorry. I'm already picking up Wendy and tosses her right back to the ring. And now, oh, emergency tag. Honey Papa, she had, I think she had it on my, oh, nice spear takedown there. Not quite an actual spear, but it was, I guess. Now, ooh, Honey Papa is like, oh, look at that chip shot. Chip shooting on Felicia, like, click, sir, make it, sir, quick, sir. Now, Honey Papa measuring Morgan. Ooh, another famous move around here. The double rocket to the apron. And Morgan didn't feel that as much because she's in full of fury as Felicia might be, but and Annie is just going in there. And now we go for another count. For the count, one, two, and two. Two, two, two. Annie, like a veteran, continue to pressure and perform me that move that we now call. What the hell is this legal? And look at her. I'm gonna say that she's got this.
That's his cooking. Oh, he's just saying that he caught that one on the third. Don't count your head chickens before you hatch them, Mr. Popeye. But, oh, a little miscommunication going in there. Oh, that. That's a. Oh, look at that. Mona gets hooked up in the corner of their eye and just, she just, just that bullet and shot even harder with that inverted suplex. And now she wants to keep going on Wendy, but Wendy doesn't want any part of it. And plus, she's never been a woman, so, yeah. Now, tossing Pop Annie to the corner to continue the fight. And, oh, Annie just gets away from her. Exactly. But then you're going to be just trying to go for another favor. That failed. Annie punches and she's going for a, ooh, that's the sidewalk backbreaker there. Not with a wrench like her partner of ooh, nasty DDT there by Morrigan to Annie. And now it's to the corner again. Now she's facing herself and she tags on to Felicia and, oh boy. I'm not calling that news, I'm sorry. I'm not calling that. And ooh, emergency tag from Maddie Popeye to Wendy. Oh boy. This is gonna be good. And a single leg drop kick. And here we go. One, two, ooh. That would have been humiliating. And what better way to shut a person up and humiliate them like that? Oh, that's good. Well, that's the only thing better to cause pain, I guess. Oh, nice flip there by Wendy. Oh, that great flip in the move. You know, mention how cool this woman could be. Oh, he's gonna do it. I think you're gonna do it. Just better connect right there. Here we go. One, two, and ooh. Two is gonna pull it through the two. And for all intents and purposes, Wendy can afford to kill this good. And ooh, whoa. And another one. And ooh, single leg drop kick. Like I was saying, Wendy could afford to. And crap. I think Felicia is seeing red. I think she's ready to bite his crap. And Addie Puppet wants to get in, but that's not going to help her partner very much, is it? And now Felicia's the one who's going to go for one hell of a double drop into the apron. And I think she might have hit her in the mouth with that one. Here we go. One. Oh, nice break up there. Great teamwork by Annie there. Oh, no. Ooh. Darkness vision right there. I get it. Oh, he's good. I get it. One, two. And this time, the Night Warrior got a modicum of revenge on the FFO by winning this match. The FFO showing a tremendous result in this one, but in the end, the fury, the wrath, the heat, that these two ladies were feeling in their hearts was enough to see them through and to get a modicum of vengeance for their currently calling CAWmbat team, who we wish the best over there in the hospital right here. Congratulations to the Lady Night Warriors on their victory. And this might be a lesson for Wendy to all be more measured with her work.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. Morgan and Felicia, representing the Night Warriors.
Oh, look at that. That's a tribute to me if I ever see one. That was cool. I like that. That was cool. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a lot more to come after this. Which means the main event of the night is coming. After them, in good order, we want to see who will go against the FFO for the Tactical Championship. We'll be right back.
If you haven't subscribed to the Video Game Wrestling Network yet,
Here's what you've been missing.
Video Game Wrestling Network, the only network for you. The most awesome experience network in CAW today.
They put their bodies, their careers, and their lives on the line. They have spent years training and have a lifetime of experience. But what entertains you tears their bodies apart. So cheer for them, admire them, believe in them, but leave the action to them. Please do not try this at home.
Welcome to the last match of the night, which promises to be victorious.
Yeah, like my little macho concert friend there, I hope to do. Well, despite this being a friendly bar more than anything, it also serves as a purpose. This guy, Muscle Mac, wants to be the one to represent the Nintendo Order against the FFO, current reigning defending CAWmbat Wrestling Tag 4 champion, them being the Burger King and Chuck E. Cheese. Will they be able to succeed, or will their opponents be able to succeed? And this opponent are... what a four, damn Mario. The veterans of this ring who want to be the ones to capture the goal for the old.
And opponent, the team of Mario and Luigi Fratelli, the Super Mario Brother.
You look at a dictionary, the words are decorated as beautiful pictures. You will see this too in there. And center. This two have had more goals in the state of the world than most other tag teams that we know. From the early days of No DQ and Savage Jam all the way to now, and now they want to add another set of belts to their own illustrious resume, the CAWmbat Wrestling Tag 4 Championship. But the only thing standing in the way right now is the partner and very good friend in the Nintendo Order, Macho Club,
and little man. Will they be able to succeed? Will they be able to be the one to go to our next big event and fight for the Jackpot Championship? So will Front the Mac represent the Nintendo Order at the new tag in town? We will find out in just a few seconds.
The final match of the night, the main event, the Nintendo Order takes the spotlight as referee Jussei Arafat calls for the bell. Seems to me that the macho fox is hungry for gold, but never underestimate the veteran skills of the Mario brothers. Mario being the heftier of the two, you know, the more physically imposing. Oh, first with a butterfly to put the now with that takedown. Now Mario covers low to the back of Fox, pressing into the corner, hard. And now here we go with a step to the ground. Ooh, nicely evaded by Fox, who runs from him. Oh, nice takedown. Now, and mind you, these guys are fresh, and they're hitting each other like that. Imagine what they're willing to do to the FFO. I think this is they're sending us some kind of a letter, if you will. Now, Fox doubles Mario through the corner. Ooh, nice hard clothesline in that game. Now Mario retaliates by throwing through the rose leg. Oh, look at that. That's almost like the Cosmo effect. Shades of Timmy Turner from RCCW. By the way, shout out to RCCW. Hey, if you guys are watching, big up to you guys. Now Fox tossing Mario to his corner. Well, I thought he was going to attack the Mac, but I think Mario read that telegram now. He tosses to his corner. He's going to pass it to the Luigi and yep. These guys know each other way too well, I think. All of them know each other way too well. Oh, he does that to Mac. And, oh, boy. This is not looking good. Oh, two men on slingshot through the corner. And now, oh, boy. Oh, look at the power up. Oh, little Mac. Oh, the veteran skill from Mario getting up on that attempt at a power bomb. Kick to the gut. Now he's going to attempt at a suplex. Nope, little Mac read that telegram. Oh, nice punch. Just so you know that he's not only a punching kind of guy. Now he's dropping the legs and nothing's just as powerful as his punch. Let me tell you. So is that field goal. Now, oh boy. Here we go for the early goal. With his signature maneuver, Lion Sting connect right there. And is he going to hit him with the punch out yet? No, not yet. He's going to continue the pressure. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said before, I say again, this is the water break, if you'll excuse me. Why it always feels so good to have some half down like an answer, you know? And here we go with a pin. One. Ooh, see the veteran skills. Luigi just went for to break that pin, and he managed to hit the referee without even noticing. They're going to say nothing. That's just them Mario's up that bag of tricks. And Fox was going to go for the macho elbow, and that failed completely. No water at the pool, like, I'm afraid. And here we go with that power bomb into a belly to back. Oh, duplex there. Demonstrating a little bit of power of his own, I told you. He's the stuffy one of the city. And now he tosses him to his corner. Ooh, he saw that. He saw the danger of being in there. And now Fox tosses him to his corner. And he successfully attacks his Mac. And, oh, boy. Up they go. Oh, the elevation on that full person back body drop. Especially with a guy that big like little Mac. You do not want to mess with something like that. Now, speaking of that, oh, Mitch, you love the ball. I'm going to talk finale. Because I know you guys have been getting in that case. And because of me talking all that crap, I forgot to mention that he got kind of true to the two. And a back body drop of Mario Zone. And a few goals to complete that. Now he picks up little Matt. And, turns around flapjack. That's a lot of, you need a lot of power to do something like that to someone that big. And, oh, pretty powerful ability when you get finesse, right, Mario? Ever that, Mario? Here we go. Oh, that punch right there. That shape of Johnny Gat. Here we go. Here we go with, are we going to see it?
Yes, we are! The Super Smash Bomb! Super Smash Bomb, and he's gonna pin in the one! No, not even two, just one and nice edge. That's the power of Mack right there, kicking out of that Super Smash Bomb, just like that, and following up with that arm drag from that height. It never feels good, I tell you. And now, oh boy, no. No, Mack, come on, no. This is a friendly spar. Don't take it this far. Come on, no. No, Mack, don't move it. Don't get in this part of Florida. No! Fry free! And like I said, these guys are friends. They're partners. And they're doing this to each other. Just imagine what they'd be willing to do to the FFO for the CAWmbat Wrestling Tackle Championship. My God in heaven. How in the hell is Mario still up after that? This is... He must have taken his mushroom early on. Now Marty can jump into the ring for to see a little Mack. And here we go, the hot tag. Also known as an emergency tag. Now Luigi, the speedier one of the team, the acrobat of the team. Now he's going in, but ooh. Mack plays that momentum, and now he hits him with a signature maneuver. Fly and sting. Now he goes, oh, he's calling it. I think we might see it. And Mario's down, oh, the punch! And if Mario doesn't get up, this is gonna be over. And here we go. Referee Jussei Arafat in position of 1-2. Oh! How close was that? 2-2. Oh, a Goomba stomp right there. And, ooh, he dives the head right into the chest of Little Mack. Excuse me about that. Now, continuing the pressure like a veteran should. Little Mack using that power of his like he should. Ooh, spin around, makes you melt the ball. Now, Mack feels it in the bag. Mack feels the momentum. And, oh, man, it has been a match from the get-go. All cylinders. They both want to be the representative of the Nintendo against the FFO at the upcoming Mega event. And he's going with a slowing blow. It's like being hit with a sledgehammer each and every time. But he comes up to the corner. And that, oh, I thought he was going to attack to fuck, but that didn't happen. Instead, Luigi comes up to his corner. And oh, that didn't happen. And now, Mack going to back and forth. Who will make the tag? No one knows. And Mack trying to get a little air on him because them two teams have been on each other. And he's going with the sledgehammer blow again and again. I think, oh no, another one. Are we going to see it? Yes! The punch out in the jaw. He's knocked. Mario's going to get in there. And he's got it. Here we go. 1-2. Oh, what an awesome assist by Fox there. And now he's going to do it again. And nice evasion there. Oh, out of with that clothesline. That's veteran skill. That's the eye of the eagle. You've been up for years and years of being in this match. But, oh, nothing can prepare you to when you get hit with something that hard. Now, Mack attacks to Fox, and Fox proceeds to ram the head into the camera. Now Fox, I don't know what, and now sadly due to Little Mack being in the way, and you could tell he's visibly hurt. He is visibly hurt, and because of that, he wasn't able to do whatever he needed to do, and now Fox, look at Luigi just hitting him with that hard knee, and ooh, Fox retaliating with that back body drop. Now Fox, then he ran out, oh, Russian next week. And did I quote Team of Injury again? I think I should. Even the captain of the Starbucks team can do one of those. Now Luigi picking up a Fox. Oh, elbow shot to the gut. Now Fox gonna go for a stick breaker. Basic, actually it's effective. Macho elbow. Yes, both Macho Elbow. Ooh, yeah. The next right there. Here we go. 1,
2, and this time is 3. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a representative of the Nintendo Order, and their names are Macho Bunny Cloud and Metal Man.
The veterans gave her all in this match. They went through the fire, they went through the ringer. They did everything they needed to do, and for all their bag of tricks, but in the end, the two newbies were hungry. They wanted the opportunity to represent the Nintendo Order in the Mega Event, and now they got it. It will be Macho Funky Cloud and Little Man representing the Nintendo Order. Say is if they could pull the stunts like this on the Mega Event against Chuck E. Cheese and the Burger King, we might be looking at new champs, but only if they're able to pull it like that. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have on behalf of everybody here at CAWmbat Wrestling. It's a big your boy, Batman Juan. So long, everybody. Wait a minute. Well, so much coming up. That's the Thunder Bolt. What are they? What
the hell?
Why are they doing this? They're just attacking the but fuck the Mac after this hard battle. And what? Why are they doing this? Did they ever set them or something? And that, and now we go backstage and they're also attacking Savage? What the hell is this about? Look at this. Why? Why? 56.